Today, we're going to talk about a tool that has been added to the most recent Project Manager releases. Just as its name implies, Convert&Resize is a tool allowing you to convert and change resolution of images while still remaining in the 3ds Max window. The tool can be launched from two different tabs. You can either run it when the Textures tab in the main Project Manager window is on, or start it from the Asset Files tab. In the first case, you will be able to use the tool on the files from your Textures library. If you have a scene open, you can also run the Convert and Resize tool from the Asset Files tab and change extension or resolution of any of the texture files used in this particular scene. You need to be careful though, because the tool might affect the files that are already used in your other projects. But you can prevent this from happening since the tool makes it possible to create additional folders for new files. This can be done in the Output tab. In the Output Path field, enter a unique path to the folder where you want to store your new files, or use the ready-made solution of masks, which the tool will apply to create child folders according to set parameters. You can supply your newly created folder with a prefix and a suffix describing what exactly the folder contains. If no new path is set for the new textures, their file names may conflict with those already saved in the folder. You can avoid this by setting the Overwrite, Skip or Automatic Rename options in the Name Collision field. When working with the Convert and Resize tool from the Asset Files tab, you will have an Update Scene Paths option available to you. This option automatically rewrites paths to all modified files in the scene. Let me show you the main features of the Convert and Resize tool. What the tool does is convert the files from a scene or a library. You can also use it to resize your textures, changing their resolution. The conversion capabilities are so far somewhat limited. However, the tool can read any format, including such specific ones as PSD, OpenEXR, HDR, and TX. In the Settings tab, you can configure different save settings, such as compression, gamma, alpha channel, etc. The Resize tab offers many tools to adjust the size of the texture. The Presets tab allows you to choose a ready-to-use preset that would fit your needs. In the Mode and Size tabs, you can control your resize logic and the required resolution. The Allow Stretch option allows you enlarging smaller images. If this option is off, however, you will only be able to reduce the image size. To my mind, enlarging the images does not make much sense, since standard resampling algorithms aren't capable of restoring the details of small images. This is why I prefer to keep this option unchecked. The Resample tab allows choosing different pixel sampling algorithms. By default, it is set to the most common bicubic filter. In the last of the Settings tabs, Original Files, you can choose the option to delete the original files after they have been converted or resized. Here you can also set the option to safely delete your files to the bin, if the system where your files are stored allows that. You can separate the processes of converting and resizing from one another by checking or unchecking the corresponding box. The Convert and Resize tool is launched by clicking the Start button. Obviously, this utility will not be in demand quite often, but when it comes to these particular tasks, it has no rivals. The tool will convert, resize, and relink all your project textures. And all this is done with just a few clicks. If you haven't yet installed Project Manager, follow the link in the description to this video and get yourself this indispensable plugin. Take care and fast renderings to you all.